We're talking about the number 16. 16 is a very special number to me. It's my actual favourite number.
One of my favourite numbers is 16. And a lot of people seem to like 16, even though it is an even number. It wins out for being a square number.
It's partially favourite because I was born on the 16th day of December, to be precise. And I always liked it because when I was sweet 16 on the 16th, I could do a lot of things by then. I could go off and get married if I wanted to. I could leave school legally. I didn't, of course. But 16 is also mathematically very special. It's the square of a perfect square. Did you know that?
No, come on then.
Would you like me to explain?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Square of a perfect square.
Yes,
yeah,
so a perfect square, a good example, is 2 squared. 2 squared, you get 4. It's perfect because I've got 2 to the power of 2. It's the same digit. If I square this, so all of that squared, so this is 4 squared, lo and behold, we get 16, my favourite number.
And I was at a pub once with some friends of mine, and we were drinking and having fun, and we thought we'd order some food. We were on table 16. I went up to the bar and I said, to get food, can we get delivered to 16? I went, oh, wait a minute. Which is 4 squared. Can I order food to the table 4 squared? And the poor girl behind the bar looked very confused. I went, oh, no, actually, we'll make it easier. How about I order it to 2 to the 4? Because not only is 16 4 times 4, it's also 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And then at this point, she looked very bewildered. And later on, we managed to intercept her food on the way to table 24.
Let's say I have the relationship x raised to the power of y. So x and y are 2 different integer numbers. So x cannot equal y. So x could be 2, y could be 3. We'd have 2 cubed. Now the only relation that is satisfied by this number 16 is that x to the y is equal to y to the x. So the number on this side of your equal sign is going to be exactly the same as the number on this side of the equal sign. To do that, I'm going to take the number x is going to be, let's say, 4. And let's take y to be 2. If we interpret those onto the other side of the equation, y was 2 and x was 4. 4 to the power 2, we've already seen it's 16. 2 raised that to the power 4, you put it into your calculator, what do you get? 16. And 2 and 4 are the only numbers that can be interpreted as x and y in order to get this relationship, this special number, 16.
And we thought there must be other numbers. And we had a bit of a chat and we realised none of us knew. And we all do maths things for a living. And we thought, let's work it out, we decided, because you could look it up. We could go online and see if anyone else would try this. And we thought, no, it's as much fun to work this out as if no one else ever has. And some people went away and started trying to write computer software to see if there are bigger ones. And the rest of us were like, some people were drawing graphs, some people were doing number theory stuff. And a lot of prime factors suddenly appeared. And other people, because this went across many evenings, other people were like, what are you guys doing? I'm like, we're trying to work out if 16 is the only number where you can write it to x to the y or y to the x.
You cannot get any other number using any other integers to get a number that equals itself.
16 is the only number, and we've since realised other people do know about this, and it's a nice property of 16, but we had the joy of working it out for ourselves. And so if you get bored, you can check why, and it's fascinating why 16 is the only number that does that.
That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. I think so.
Yeah.
Well, initially it was just a lot of arguing over food. So people walking by just saw us eating, and someone would go, "But what about 64?" And then there'd be a bit, and then someone else would go, "No, not 64." And we go, "Oh, okay," and we're back to the food.
Is that why it's your favourite number, or is it just because of your birthday?
Because it's my birthday. This is just a cool relationship.
Often during lessons, we'd be like, what if it's, and then someone would go, I've got a log, check out this log graph. This is it. We're going, oh, I don't know. And actually, this was the beginning, if I can get distracted briefly, this was the beginning of something called Maths Jam, which is an organization I run where people get together in a pub and do maths, because we realized we started off in this pub drinking and we accidentally did maths. And then later on, we were doing more and more, and other puzzles started to show up. We realised that 36 is both a square number and a triangle number, but that's a whole different video. And we suddenly thought, why are we having these debates when we're meant to be teaching school kids? Why don't we get rid of the school kids and just replace them with tasty beverages? And so ever since, and now it's all around the world. There are last count 14 or 15 different cities in the UK and other countries have mass jams where people get together on the second last Tuesday of the month and talk about maths and do problems and play with toys and yeah, all because I sat down in a pub at table 16.